Mongoose Jake with my review on the Nerf Doomlands Judge. Now, I'll go over my typical kind of four topics. The product and the price you pay for it, and what's included. The features that it has. The performance that we can get out of it. As well as, what do I finally think of it? My final verdict. Now, the Judge is, let's face it, it's a huge monster. And it costs a pretty high amount. $60 is the basic expected retail price you're going to pay for this. That's what it costs approximately on Target and Kmart's website, which is, I got mine from Target, and I did pay $59.99 at the time. Now they're a couple dollars cheaper, but still, it's a $60 blaster. Comes with enough darts to fill it up, and it does take quite a bit to fill it up. I have just a few here. It takes three darts per burst, and it has 10 bursts in it. So a total of 30 darts to fill the drum. And it is a rotating drum up front with the mechanism, and it has a pump action lever. It comes with the Elite style darts with the Doomlands color. That's a yellowish orange foam with a black tip. Now when we load these in, of course you can load three, but I also want to show I have a standard Elite and an AccuStrike in here, and you can do that to gain a little range, not a lot. I did a range test, and I will put a link in the description below, as well as up above in a card form, so check that out if you want to see that. My wife volunteered to be a guinea pig for a different kind of range test, and I think it showcases what this can do quite well, so please do check that out. Now, I will rate the performance as more than adequate for what this is intended to do. And what's it intended to do? Well, it features 30 darts loaded into 10 shots of 3-round bursts. Pump action, and it is meant to be a close quarters blaster. Simply put, it is a limited effectiveness in other areas, but massively effective in its intended use. Now, to go over the features of the blaster, it's basically this. Again, 30 shots divided up into 10 bursts of 3 darts. Pump action. It has a see-through port that allows you to see part of the mechanism of the blaster, and a large pistol grip. It has multiple sling points. Here, this whole thing could become a sling point. Here, and nowhere else is there anything. It does have one tactical rail. I don't know why you would use it. Maybe a flashlight if you do some nighttime Nerf, which we do. I haven't used this one in any nighttime battles yet, but yes, you can put a flashlight up on top. But I do run it on a single point sling. I tend to like this one right back here. Easy to clip a sling on, and then throw it over your neck and shoulder and keep it off to your side so that then, if the need arises, you can easily pull it around. Now, to load it, of course, just throw some darts, front-loaded style. I've already pumped it. Have a 3-round burst ready to fire. Pull the trigger and fire. The darts up close will not spread much. The darts actually start to spread out into a true shotgun pattern at about 10 feet, and then continue on from there. To the point where if somebody's between, say, 10 to 20, 25 feet away from you, you're pretty much going to hit them. It's almost a guaranteed tag. When you point, pump, and fire with three, that was a single shot, and I'm showing that it's possible. The single shot will turn it into a much more effective blaster at range. But I would only do that with maybe a couple, and you could easily just pull a couple darts out after you've loaded it, because that is something I have done in usage. Is if I see somebody at long range, my primary is out, and I have this ready in my hands and loaded. If I see somebody at longer range, well, just reach over here, look at your next chamber of darts, and pull out the top two, leave the bottom one, and then pump to it and fire. It does give you a little range boost, because basically it takes the plunger tube's air that it has pumped out through the system, and each of the three, which are there, three individual barrels there, they each have their own individual air restrictor. So if each dart is in there, it depresses all three air restrictors, and then the air is divided into the three barrels, you know, and split. Well, removing one or two darts then now forces all of the air into one, or two if you have just only removed one, and so it gets more effective velocities, but it's not a flat rate. You know, it's not like if I pull out two darts and I'm only firing one instead of three, it goes three times further. It's not how it works. It's not a pure efficiency like that. The air restrictors are inefficient by design, and pulling one out, it might gain you an extra 10, 15 feet. So don't expect all of a sudden that this is going to become the world-changing sniper if you just load one single dart. But it is something you can do. Now, that out of the way, have I had any issues with this? I have ran this quite a bit, actually. And yes, I have had some issues. You would think that a $60 blaster that's been through all of Nerf's glorious R&D would be flawless. Well, especially by the time it hits the consumers and the purchasing public, it should be. But it's not. This rotational mechanism has had a number of issues. Now, would I call them fatal flaws? No. It's just that due to the size and weight of this, and me being active in my role, I don't just sit there and take hot shots from range of people. I actively run, and I'm running gun all the time. So with this especially, you need to be that type of Nerf player. Get close, get up into cover, be moving around, and with that movement, I think it upsets the mechanism of this to a point where sometimes it doesn't get a full rotation in. And it will, instead of a nice clean rotation like that, it will stop, like say 90% turned, and because of the locks inherent in all Nerf blasters, it won't let you fire. You can reach around and bump that and finish the rotation, or force another pump and it'll finish the rotation and then fire. Does it happen a lot? No, but I wouldn't be a good reviewer if I didn't mention the fact that it does happen. And that's why, especially why I want to do long-term reviews. I've had this thing for months now. And while I would definitely, I'm gonna go ahead and spoil it, and I definitely would recommend this if you're that type of player that likes close quarters blasters, especially with something as unique as this, it fills its role extremely well. But it does have that. And you're probably, if you pick one up, you're probably gonna run into it. And unlike some Nerf reviewers who will just say that they tested and they had no jams or malfunctions of any kind while firing a few hundred darts, I'm gonna tell you that, well yeah, while running around and sliding and jumping, moving around, firing over, around, and up and down between cover and barriers, yes, I have gotten some issues with this, but I'm still gonna wholeheartedly recommend it. And here's why. I'm not the biggest Nerf fan in the world, and that if you've watched my videos, that's probably become apparent. I think Nerf overprices a lot of their blasters. They repackage a lot of the exact same things featuring the same technology over and over. They basically, to me, have become a flywheel blaster company where you're going to get a rev trigger, you're going to get a main trigger, you're going to get some batteries thrown in, you're going to get a flywheel cage, magazine fed, aka Strife, aka Rapid Strike, aka Modulus, ECS-10, then okay, somewhat more ingenuitive, the Hyperfire, the Desolator is basically a different version of Strife. You know, you get my point. It's going to be magazine-fed, flywheel-powered. And that's fine. They do that very, very, very well. And then they produce something like this, and it changes my opinion. This is genuinely original. It's a big, chunky, honking blaster that is a huge pump action shotgun that fires multiple bursts, and it's just gloriously awesome. This brings out the kid in me again. And yes, I'm still that hyped about it. Give it the fact that it's got an issue once in a while with the rotation. I still love this thing. This has definitely just made it onto my list of top favorite blasters of all time. And that's how hyped I am about this blaster. And I hope that becomes apparent in my review. Yes, it's got a flaw. Yes, the thing's overpriced. And I'll tell you that right off the bat. It is overpriced. $60 is just too much. It is. I paid it. I paid it when I had excess amount of money. It was, and I had a blaster budget, and it was part of it. And this thing is worth, it's worth a bit less than that. It's still awesome. I wouldn't recommend you go run out and spend $60 on it right now. If you want to, go for it. But I'd wait for it to go on sale. It is not perfect. The rotational mechanism should have been made a little bit heavier duty, but it's not a fatal issue. This thing still, with reasonable usage, I'm not a reasonable user. I will push a blaster to the limit. I'm an adult running around using them hard. Most people, they might not ever see that issue, but I do. Now, it works well. The ranges are what you expect. I'm not gonna chrono it. What's the point? The thing will be effective up to around 30, 35 feet. If you're attempting to shoot further than that, you're gonna be lobbing these shots like a Hail Mary pass, and it's not going to be very effective. But indoors, around corners, around barriers, at close range, Nerf arenas, I will actually at some point be filming me using this at my local Nerf arena that just opened, and I think this thing will be one of the best blasters. The only other one that I think that would beat this would be running a Busby Destiny with multiple clips, and that thing would just be murderous. But this thing would be very effective with just carrying around a pouch of darts, slapping them in, and then like that. That can lay down some serious firepower very quickly and very effectively at close range. So should it be your only blaster? No. But I credit Nerf for making something completely original and unique, and that's something they need to do a whole lot more of. Because other companies are beating them in that originality department. I mean, now you just got the Dart Zone Command Fire that's under the Adventure Force label, but that thing's unique. The Busby Destiny is pretty unique. The Busby Monorail is really unique. And you got Dart Zone Magnum. You've got other brands making blasters that haven't been seen. Well, once again, it's not Nerf's Elite line that makes something that's truly unique. Is it the other lines? You got the Zombie Strike up here with the Sledge Fire. That thing is awesome. I'm putting this right in there. It's a very unique and original blaster from Nerf, and I would highly recommend it. Hopefully you can pick it up on sale. And that would be my review of it. This is Mungo State, thanking you for watching my review of the Nerf Doomlands Judge. Hope you enjoyed it, and thanks for staying to the end.